If you know the enemy and know yourself, you need not fear the result of 100 battles. If you know yourself but not the enemy, for every victory gained, you'll also suffer a defeat. If you know neither the enemy nor yourself, you will succumb in every battle. These ideas come from Chinese general and philosopher Sun Tzu's The Art of War, a Chinese military treatise going back to 5th century BC. Incredibly enough, over 2,500 years later, each of those 3 points directly applies to the world of cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is a great umbrella term referring to protecting the confidentiality, integrity, and availability of computing devices and networks, hardware and software, and most importantly, data and information. Cybersecurity involves times when data or information is in transit, being processed, and at rest. Cybersecurity is achieved through procedures, products, and people. We're going to investigate these terms and concepts throughout the course. Some like to think of cybersecurity as a subset of information security, a very general term which also deals with information stored physically, in addition to cybersecurity's pure digital form. Cybersecurity requires knowing who the hackers are, who the attackers are, what their motivations are, where our vulnerabilities lie, and how protected we actually are. Easier said than done. What exactly is cyberspace? The enemy could be thousands of miles away, or in the very next cubicle at work, or both, if the attacker has penetrated your network and is sitting silently, watching and observing, collecting tons of information until the time comes to launch the attack. Nowadays, attackers lurk on networks silently just watching for hundreds of days at a time, completely undetected. This is a constant cat and mouse game. Companies pay penetration testers to find and exploit vulnerabilities. Pen testers can make recommendations, but what good are they if the companies don't implement them? What good are they if the companies do implement them to check off compliance boxes and then don't actively monitor their infrastructure afterwards? What good are hardware and security implementations if the weakest link, the humans, fall victim to social engineering attacks, which don't involve any technology, but rather prey on the gullible and naive humans? We've heard too many of these link-clicking stories. Who's to blame if the employees are not properly educated and trained? Who's to blame if the employees are educated and trained, but not tested to see not only what they learned, but how they will react in certain situations? We often fear the unknown hackers from the outside, but insiders are a much greater threat and can do far greater damage. They already have some level of access, means, and opportunity. One of the biggest problems today in cybersecurity is the putting out fires mentality, stopping the hackers. However, treating each attack as an isolated incident is a huge mistake. There needs to be greater intelligence correlating attacks to previous attacks, both within a company and between companies. The more intel that can link one attack to a previous one, the more equipped we can be in protecting ourselves going forward. The hackers are doing far more sharing and collaborating than the good guys.